What feelings do you get when you think of repentance? Do you feel uncomfortable? Do you feel like it's a nasty term? Like a Bible thumping, you need to change, you need to do this to be a better person? Do you think of rules and regulations and what you need to do to be better and know God, to make God happy and love you more? That was my view of repentance for a very long time, until I started repenting, and then I started to have this new revelation and understanding of what it really is. God never really used that word with me in the beginning when he was teaching me about it. All he did was change my heart. And he gave me a desire, like a real desire, to want to change, to want to know him better, and to want to be better. And it wasn't out of wanting or striving to be the best that I can so that God will love me and accept me. It was like God was starting to show me the things that needed to shift in my heart, so that I could become free, so that I could actually become free of the things that are holding me back and actually detrimental to me, so that I could live my fullest life and the life that God was always calling me to. He started giving me these feelings of wanting to do things differently, of wanting to do things this way compared to the way that I've always been doing. And I've always wanted to act. Now I started wanting to act this way. There were things in my life that I couldn't give up or even wanted to give up for the life of me. But when I invited God into my heart and told him that I wanted him and that I wanted to know who I was created to be, these things just fell off. I had new and right desires, and the only explanation for it is that God came into my heart and changed those desires miraculously. Once he did that, I realized that there really is a path to freedom, that there really are ways that we're acting that are contrary to how we should be, because it's a burden, it's actually holding us back, and we're not living to our full potential of who we were created to be. And the reason why we do that is a lack of understanding and a lack of knowledge of who God is, and not having him reign in our lives. So when I started to live a new life in certain areas, completely free from the bondage of whatever I was stuck in and whatever mentality or lifestyle I was stuck in, not everything fell off in my life that way. There were still things that I had to deal with and walk through. There were still mindsets that I knew were not in line with God, but I still dealt with. So once God gave me that basis and that understanding that I could be free, then he showed me how to become free through true repentance on my part. So there were things that God did by the power of the Holy Spirit in my life to show me, I think to give me the revelation. And then there were things that he allowed me to walk through to see this is totally contrary to God, contrary to how I should be living, and contrary to the word. So I want to make the decision to repent. Now, what repentance really means is it means doing a complete 180 flip, going the other direction, and realizing that what you're doing, you probably shouldn't be doing. It's wanting to, genuinely desiring to make a change. It's not you must change your ways because you have to, because God said so, because this. God cares about your heart. He doesn't want you to repent or to change your actions because you think it's going to make you a better person in his sight, and that's it. He wants you to make a change and repent because you love him and because you've come to that realization that it's going to set you free. If you think of it any other way, it's just going to cause you to feel bitterness and angry towards God, angry even that you're unable to change by yourself and you're struggling against these habits. God doesn't want you to go alone in this. He never has, and he never will leave you alone in this. If you take the first effort and say, okay, God, this is something that I want to work through, I know you want to help me through, then give it to him and watch him do the work in you. But there are just some things that he really wants to see. You're willing to change. You're willing to give up. Willing to at least inquire of him, is this something, Lord, that I need to stop doing? Permanent and lasting freedom and change never comes out of our own strength and our own abilities to make things work and change in our lives. They always come from that relationship with the Lord and asking him to lead you in it. And that, my friends, is the heart of repentance.